啊，感谢主啊！我们今天有很多人来参加我们的成人神训班。
And thank God we have so many people attending the National Adult Theological Seminar.
啊，那在被安排祷告会期间，我想跟大家一起来学习古圣徒的代求。
And I'd like to share as mutual encouragement, intercession of Saints Abraham.
我们当中大部分的参加学员都是有一点年纪啊。
Most of the attendees here are the students. They have a little bit of age.
Oh, 那有的已经退休了。
And some have retired already.
感谢主，我们在追求信仰的热忱没有改变。
And thank God the pursuit and zealousness of spiritual faith has not changed.
那我们常常想那我接受训练以后，我回到地方教会，我要怎么来服侍神？
And so we often think that after we receive this training, returning back to our local church, how would we serve God?
那有时候我们发现，好像很多的事工，好像我们很难参与。
And sometimes we'll realize it's hard for us to participate any type of holy work.
比方说讲道的事工，这需要有特别的恩赐。
And for example, delivering sermon would require special gifts.
那很多的其他的事工年轻的一辈都有很有恩赐的，已经积极的参与。
And so, other works in church, some of the gifted youth has already participated.
所以到底我们能够为教会做什么？
So, what can we possibly do to help church?
那其中有一件圣工，每一个人都可以做。
And there's a holy work that every one of us can participate.
也可以说，没有一个是退休的。
In other words, there's no retirement limitation.
这个就是代祷代求。
And this will be an intercessory prayer with intercession.
今天在祷告之前，我们就来学习亚伯拉罕的代求。
And so today, before we pray, we will study Abraham's intercession.
通过我们的代求，能够带给别人很多神的恩典。
Through our intercession, God's grace will bring upon other people.
虽然我们算不了什么。
And although we're not worthy of anything,
圣经说我们是微尘，
and the Bible describes us as dust,
神非常的伟大，
and God is almighty,
神什么都可以做，
and God can do anything,
神也是怜悯的神，
and God's also a merciful God.
所以如果通过我们祷告感动神，神可以做很多事情。
Our prayer and then it touched upon God, God can do many things.
所以我们通过我们的代求可以帮助很多的人。
And through our intercession, actually, will bring much help to many people.
虽然年纪很大，我们也可以代求。
And although we're elderly, but we can have intercession.
虽然年纪很轻，我们也可以代求。
And although we're very young, we can also have intercession.
有时候我们常常想，我们要爱每一个人，那怎么去爱呢？
Think that we want to love everyone, and how is that possible?
但是如果通过我们的祷告我们就可以去爱每一个人。
And through our prayer, we are capable of love everybody.
比方说我们教会里面如果一个教会有100个人。
If, for example, in our church, if there's
我们现在 NCC 的统计大概是三分之二是 active member 是有在参与聚会。
And through the statistics of National Church Conference, about two-thirds of the general congregation are active
那差不多有三分之一就是 在信仰是 inactive， 就是没有很积极。
And so about a third of the members, their faith is inactive.
所以如果我们能够每一次祷告一个一个为他们代祷。
If we are able to pray for them, one by one, every time when we pray,
那我们已经在爱那一些人，我们已经在参与教会的事工。
And then we are loving those people, and we are participating in the church's holy work.
那有时候我们觉得好像祷告不晓得要祷告什么。
And sometimes we may feel that we don't know what to pray about.
特别当我们很平安、很顺利的时候。
And especially during the time that we're very peaceful.
我们不晓得祷告什么。
Peaceful and smooth. And what do we pray about?
但是当我们开始为别人祷告。
But when we start to pray for other people.
我们就发现我们真的有很多可以祷告。
And we realize that there are a lot of things that we can pray about.
有时候我们祷告要祷告30分钟，觉得哇，时间好长不晓得我这个30分钟要祷告什么。
And so sometimes during our prayer, because of the time, 30 minutes seems a bit much. We don't know what we should be praying about.
但是如果我们教会里面的比较需要祷告，你把它写一个名单，这样一个一个为他们祷告。
But if you put together a list of people in our church that require our prayer and would pray for them one by one，
那忽然间我们就发现真的三十分钟一下就过去了。
And so suddenly you will realize that 30 minutes will pass.Very quickly.
所以要爱每一个人是可能的。
And so it is possible to love everybody.
就是通过我们的代求。
And so this is through our intercession.
年纪大要服侍神是可能的。
It's possible for you to serve God if you're elderly.
就是通过我们的代求。
And this is through our intercession.
要帮助在很远地方的人是可能的。
And it's possible to help people that are
away. 就是通过我们的代求。
This is through our intercession.
好，那我们现在来看亚伯拉罕的代求。
And so we will get the intercession of Abraham.
好，我们现在来看创世纪的十九章。
And let's turn to Genesis chapter 19.
创世纪的十九章。
Genesis chapter 19.
十九章的二十九节。
Genesis chapter 19, verse 29.
十九章二十九节，我来念当神毁灭平原诸城的时候，他纪念亚伯拉罕，正在天父罗德所在之城的时候，就打发罗德从倾覆之中出来。这个地方讲神在毁灭索多玛的时候。
At the time when God destroyed the city of Sodom.
神差遣天使把罗德从索多玛救出来。
God has sent out angels to help and deliver Lot out of the city.
如果神没有差天使把罗德救出来，罗德一家人就全部被流亡火烧掉了。
Sent angels to deliver Lot and his entire household out of the city, then his family will be burned into ashes by the sulfuric fire.
那为什么神会把罗德从索多玛救出来？
Why did God deliver Lot out of Sodom?
这个地方说，因为神纪念亚伯拉罕。
And it records here that God remembered Abraham.
不是神纪念罗德，是神纪念亚伯拉罕。
And this is not God remembered Abraham.
所以亚伯拉罕的祷告蒙神纪念，神就施恩给罗德， 把他从索多玛救出来。
So the intercession of Abraham, to God, God remembered this. So God had delivered Lot out of Sodom.
好，那今天我们就来想，那今天是谁住在索多玛？
And so we should think about this today. Who dwells in the city of Sodom?
好，我们来看《创世纪》的十三章。
And let's turn to Genesis chapter 13.
好，《创世纪》的十三章。
Genesis chapter 13.
十三章的第十节。
Genesis chapter 13, verse 10.
第十节讲罗德举目看见约旦河全平原直到索尔都是滋润的、啊、那地在神未灭索多玛俄摩拉、啊、以先如同神的园子也像埃及、啊、十一节
verse 11、
啊、于是罗德选择约旦河的全平原往东迁移，他们就彼此分离。十二节。
12.
亚伯兰住在迦南地，罗德住在平原的城邑，渐渐挪移帐篷，直到索多玛。十三节。
13.
索多玛人在神的面前罪恶极大。这个地方在描写罗德的信仰旅程。
And so here recorded the journey of Lot, spiritual journey.
罗德是跟着亚伯拉罕、从他的故乡出来的。
And Lot actually followed Abraham from his hometown.
所以罗德是跟着亚伯拉罕进入迦南地。
And so Lot followed Abraham entering into the land of Canaan.
那亚伯拉罕到迦南地，他是因为照着神吩咐他去做。
The reason that Abraham went to the land of Canaan was because that he followed the instruction and guidance of God.
但是罗德、他的信仰怎样我们不知道。
But we don't know what Lot's faith is.
那一直到亚伯兰跟罗德分开我们就看到罗德的信仰。
And until the point that when after Abraham was separated from Lot, we saw Lot's faith.
今天、我们教会里面的第二代、第三代、面对信仰极大的挑战。
And in our church, our second generation, third generation of members, they face great trials or challenges in their faith.
我们上一代或者我们这一代有了年纪的人，都是在、很、很单纯的环境长大。
And the generation prior or this generation, we sort of grew up in a very simple environment.
单纯啊，单纯的环境长大。
Very, very naive environment.
但是啊，我们现在啊，这一代啊，所面对的环境实在是跟索多玛差不多。
But this generation, indeed, the environment that they face was similar of that to Sodom.
所以十三节啊，在讲啊，索多玛在神的面前罪恶极大。
And so verse 13, for the men of Sodom were exceedingly wicked.
所以我们现在这个社会里面啊，这个罪已经被包装过。
And so in this society, the sin actually had been packaged in a way.
就是用文化来包装。
And it has been packaged through culture.
所以罪变成文化的一部分。
And so the sin became a way of a culture.
因此大家都在做。
And so everybody is doing it.
那我们的年轻一代他要怎么办？
And so our younger generation, what should they do?
所以我们仔细看当罗德跟亚伯兰分开。
Just carefully that when Lot separated from Abraham.
第十节讲他举目观看约旦河全平原。
In verse 10, it recorded that he lifted up his eyes and saw the plains of Jordan.
那第十节的后半在讲索多玛、俄摩拉如同神的原子也像埃及地。
And the second part of this recorded Sodom and Gomorrah like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt.
也就是说非常好、非常漂亮、非常吸引人。
And in other words, this is how wonderful, how beautiful, and it's very attractive.
这个就是现在的世界。
So this is the world that we have today.
如果我们看用眼睛来看很多很吸引人、很有趣的地方、很快乐的地方。 其实里面都是有罪的。
And so if we look at the world with our eyes, there are many places that's very attractive and exciting or good, but hidden within is actually sin.
所以十一节，罗德就往东迁移。
And so verse 11, then Lot slowly drifted towards the east.
那迁到哪里去? 迁到索多玛的旁边。And
he journeyed next to Sodom.
他又不敢进到里面去，所以他住在索多玛的城外面。He
was afraid to enter in the city, so he would only dwell on the outskirts of the city.
在彼得前书里面讲，罗德的义心天天伤痛。
And so in 1 Peter, it recorded that the heart of righteousness of Lot was painfully at stake every day.
罗德的心还有一个良心，看到周围的人所犯的罪，他的心很难过。
And so Lot actually carried a heart of conscience. So when he saw all the people that were committing sin around him, he felt very painful, sorrowful.
我们现在这个世界，如果比较跟索多玛差不多。And
so our world is comparable to the time of the city of Sodom.
当时的索多玛就是淫乱跟暴力。And
so the city of Sodom at the time had sexual immorality and a lot of violence.
最近在看到天主教的教宗，他也同意同性恋。
So recently, we saw that the Pope of the Catholic Church also agreed to homosexuality.
那全世界有五个国家开始最先承认同性恋合法化。
And so in the whole entire world, there was five nations who legalized marriage of homosexual marriage.
那这个五个国家里面，本来都是以基督教为主的。
And these five countries originally were considered Christian nations.
所以同性恋变成社会的文化。
Sexuality became the culture of the world.
Homosexual. 所以这个对我们下一代影响非常大。
And so this deeply affected next generation.
因此罗德搬到索多玛，就是搬到罪恶之城的旁边了。
And so Lot journeyed to the outskirts of the city of Sodom, which is the sinful city.
这是我们现在年轻一代所面对极大的考验。
And so this is the greatest test and challenges faced by our younger generations today.
所以我们现在需要有亚伯拉罕。
So we need to have Abraham.
亚伯拉罕真的是爱罗德。
And Abraham indeed really loved Lot.
虽然罗德选择最好的地方。
And although Lot chose the best land for himself,
亚伯兰并没有恨罗德,
but Abraham did not hate Lot.
他对罗德的爱没有改变,
and he did not change his love towards Lot.
所以当罗德被掳走的时候, 亚伯拉罕带着300几个壮丁连夜一直追赶要把他追回来。
So when Lot was captured by the enemy, Abraham brought about 300 plus men and overnight wanted to bring him back.
那当神知道 那当罗亚伯兰知道神要毁灭索多玛，哎呀，亚伯兰就为着索多玛来代求。
And so when Abraham knew that God planned to destroy the city of Sodom, then so he prayed on their behalf.
亚伯兰的代求是有功效的。
So the intercession of Abraham is greatly effective.
如果我们看创世纪的十八章。
If we turn to Genesis chapter 18.
创世纪的十八章。
Genesis chapter 18.
22节。
22.
创世纪十八章二十二节。
Genesis chapter 18, verse 20.
两人转身离开那里，同索多玛去，但亚伯兰仍旧站在神的面前。这里讲亚伯兰站在神的面前。
And here recorded that Abraham still stood before the Lord.
我们现在祷告就是跪在神的面前。
When we pray today, we're kneeling in front of the Lord.
主耶稣说，有两三个人奉我的名祷告，我就在他们当中。
Lord Jesus Christ says that if there's two or three people pray with my name, then I will be in your midst.
所以我们现在这么多人奉主耶稣圣名祷告，主就在我们当中。
And so many people that we have today will pray in the name of Jesus Christ, and Jesus will be among us.
所以我们是跪在神的面前。
So we kneel before the Lord.
那亚伯兰就开始代求。
And Abraham started to pray.
所以24节如果这个城有50个亿人，你还要毁灭吗？
In verse 24, suppose there were 50 righteous within the city, would you also destroy the place?
所以神要毁灭索多玛是因为神的公义，神不能够容忍罪恶。
And so the reason that God wanted to destroy the city of Sodom was due to his righteousness. He cannot tolerate any sinfulness.
但是神也是怜悯的神。
Merciful God.
所以如果找得到50个义人，神就答应说我就不毁灭。
And so righteous within the city, then God promised not to destroy it.
所以26节我就因他们的缘故饶恕那地方众人。
And so verse 26, if five, I will spare all of them because of their righteousness.
所以这个整个城的人虽然犯罪，但是如果有50个义人，神还是要怜悯他们。
So the entire city population, although they committed sin, but if they were 50 righteous people, God would spare them and not destroy the city.
所以可见亚伯兰的代求真的感动了神很有功效。
So the intercession of Abraham deeply moved God and is highly effective.
但是找不到50个，所以降低到变40个。
But there wasn't 50 righteous people, so it was lowered to 40.
那降低到30个。
And then it was lowered to 30.
降低到20个。
And then lowered to 20.
所以他每一次祷告，神都答应，你找得到20个，我就要怜悯这一座城。
And so every time when he prayed, and God really promised him, if you can find so many righteous people, then I will spare the city.
所以到最后亚伯兰也不好意思说神不要生气我最后再求一次。
And so at the end, Abraham said to the Lord, do not be angry, but I would need to ask you one more time.
如果这个城有10个义人，你要毁灭吗？
And so if the city has 10 righteous, would you destroy?
那神说如果找得到10个义人，我也不毁灭。
And God answered that if you can find 10 righteous, I would spare the place.
所以索多玛神毁灭不是神没有怜悯。
And so God's destroy not because that he had no mercy.
是因为他里面没有义人。
Because that there's no righteous.
虽然找不到十个义人，但是神毁灭的时候，神就纪念亚伯兰救了罗德。
Although there were no righteous inside the city, but when God destroyed the city, he remembered Abraham and delivered Lot.
那我们就要想为什么他的祷告这么有功效。
And so we should think about why was his prayer so effective.
我们现在看雅各书的第二章。
And let's turn to James chapter 2.
雅各书的第二章。
23节 Verse 23.
从22节开始。
And let's read from verse 22.
雅各书第二章22节。可见信心与他的行为并行，而且信心因为行为得以成全。23节。
23.
这就应验经上所说，亚伯拉罕信神，这就算为他的义，他又称为神的朋友。这个地方讲亚伯兰称为神的朋友。
And here, Abraham was called the friend of God.
所以他跟神的关系很亲密。
And so he had a really close relationship with God.
因此神要毁灭所多玛的时候，他说，我岂可以不将这个事情向亚伯兰隐瞒呢？
And so when God planned to destroy the city of Sodom, he said to himself, then how can I hide this from Abraham?
因为是朋友啊，所以他要毁灭的时候，他就让亚伯兰知道。
Because they are friends, so before destroying the city, that he would let Abraham know.
那亚伯兰爱罗德就开始为他们祷告。
And because of the love towards Lot, then Abraham started to intercede for him.
那今天如果我们的祷告要发生功效，我们要做神的朋友。
And today, in order for our prayer to be effective, we have to be friends.
那怎么做神的朋友？
God first. We have to become God's friend.
如果我们回到二十二节、二十三节。
And let's turn back to 22.
就信心因为他的行为得以完全成全。
And so his work, by works, faith was made perfect.
所以我们今天信主耶稣因为信就被称义。
And today when we believe in Jesus Christ, because of faith, we are called righteous.
我们不只是神的朋友，我们是神的儿子。
Not only we are the friend of God, we are also the son of God.
所以在新约时代，我们跟神的关系比旧约时代更亲密。我们是儿子。
So in the New Testament time, our relationship is even closer to the time of Old Testament because we are the Son of God.
所以我们的祷告一定会感动我们在天上的父。
And Holy Father.
但是这个地方讲信心因行为才得成全。
But here recorded that the faith was made perfect due to his
work. 所以我们要很注重过一个敬畏神的生活。
And so we have to really focus on living in a life of God-fearing.
用这个敬畏神的生活使我们能够坦然无惧站在神面前。
And living in a God-fearing life, so this way we can stand boldly in front of Him.
那这样我们的祷告神就会垂听。
And therefore our prayer will be listened by God.
所以我们现在要一起来祷告。
So now we will all pray together.
我们为着 NATS 来代祷。
And let's pray for NATS.
那也我们来想到底罗德在哪里。
And we should think about where is Lot.
罗德可能是我们家里面的一个人。
And Lot could be a family member in our house.
罗德可能是啊，我们一个朋友。
And Locke can be one of our friends.
啊，罗德可能是我们宗教教育系里面的一个学生。
And Locke can be a student in religion.
罗德可能是我们的朋友。
His education, friend.
啊，所以我们大家啊，想想看，啊，我们这一次来为他们祷告代求。
And so we should think about them and doing our prayer, we should intercede for them.
好，那我们现在大家 unmute 啊，来祷告，时间到啊，哦，我们就会 mute， 没有声音就是时间到。
And so let's all unmute your microphones and we will pray together when the time is up, your mic will be muted.
我们一起来祷告。
And let's all pray together.